Have you ever wondered how hard it is to start 3D printing on your own? Well, you are not alone. You might remember that I painted this Mandalorian bust a few months ago, and actually this is 3D printed STL from Thingiverse. Now, back then, I didn't really have a very positive experience with 3D printing. It was too difficult for me, too hard to understand, and even when I tried it myself, it didn't go all too well. That is why this bust is 3D printed from someone else. I didn't do it on my own. I was just too afraid to do it. But, as you can already guess, Anycubic reached out to me with an offer to test their new 3D printer in a video. So here I am testing 3D printing again, but this time I'm using resin printer instead of FDM printer. So, just how hard is it to go from liquid resin to ready-to-be painted miniature? Is resin printing actually superior? Let's find out!
By the way, as you can see, most of you are not subscribed yet, so if you haven't already, consider subscribing. It's absolutely free, so yeah.
Have you tried 3D printing with FDM printer? Well, I did, and let me tell you, it wasn't great. What I got here is this Ender 3 printer, which is relatively cheap. I think it cost me around $250, and it's supposed to be this low-cost printer to get you started with 3D printing. With that in mind, you cannot really expect to print things with the finest details, but maybe you wanna use this for terrain pieces, just like I did. Unfortunately, I encountered many issues when I was doing it. First is the assembly. When you get your Ender 3, you don't receive it like this, but it is split to like 15 to 20 separate parts, and it took me several hours to put it together. Let me just say that it isn't as easy as putting together a space marine. Another thing that bothered me is that during the printing process, you are using this filament that you are supposed to leave right here, but what happened to me is that it got stuck. Basically, what happened is that the string got tangled somehow, and I wasn't able to print anymore. Of course, this doesn't happen every time, but when it does happen, it's very annoying. And the last issue, and perhaps the most important one, is that you are supposed to measure the distance between the nozzle and the hot bed yourself. So before you start printing, you take a sheet of paper and drag it between the nozzle and hot bed in all four corners so that you feel a little friction between the paper and the nozzle. In my experience, this is quite difficult to do properly, but advanced and more expensive FDM printers do this themselves anyway. But at that point you might ask, why should I invest more in FDM printer when I could get the resin one instead for the same price? And you would be absolutely correct. What I got from Anycubic is their Photon Mono resin printer, and when you visit their website, it currently costs around $229, which is very similar price tag to Ender 3 when I got it. Now, I did not use this 3D printer just yet because I wanted to go through the whole process from unboxing to my ready-to-be painted miniature with you guys. So, let's do this. Okay guys, so we got everything unboxed, and now all that is left to do is to assemble the thing, and we will use this assembly instruction guide, so it's probably gonna be pretty easy. But first,
nice.
Alright, so now we should rise the Z axis by 10 millimeters. All right, take this little thing. We should loosen up all these screws. Just so you know, this is the actual printing platform. Now, I didn't manage to do this by hand, so I probably have to use these little things. Okay, so apparently you just push it right here and voila. All right, so that was quite easy. Let's move on to page two. What I am gonna do now is take this sheet of paper and put it like this. And apparently if I now press home, it will descend automatically. So now I shall press this platform down, and apparently it's time to tighten up those little screws here. Okay, so that took me forever, but I am no Bob the Builder, okay? We are gonna go to tools. Where is tools? Oh, we are here. We will set Z to zero.
Welcome to the future.
Apparently, we should put this thing right here, I guess. So apparently now this thing should be ready for printing. All that is left to do is to get some gloves, some mask, and of course the file that we are gonna print. Okay, so just before we start with the printing process, I just want to mention a few things. The first thing is that when you order your 3D printer, you also get this memory card, and there is a file called test or something like that, and you can print that if you don't have any STL files. But since I already have some STLs that I want to print myself, I will use those instead. You can get these STLs from Thingiverse or My Mini Factory or someone's Patreon.
As you might know, when you download the files, you download them in the format called STL. However, every printer uses different file format, not straight STL. So to change the STL to the format that the printer supports, you have to use a slicer. So first, when you insert your memory card, this is what you see. There are some test files that I don't really care about at this point. But when you open this file, you get to the slicer. Once you install the program, you will see this, in all its might and glory. Simply take the STL, drag it right here, and voila! You can do here a bunch of stuff, but I'm not gonna really touch anything, but I am gonna multiply my print. So simply press Ctrl C and then Ctrl V. And we have this platypus boy three times. The question is this foreshadowing for future content? Subscribe to find out. Of course, you can use this slicer for all of the Photon printers, but I'm gonna select Photon Mono, and you can see that the default settings have changed. Then you can simply press this button and it will export it in the file format that we need. Additionally, you will see how much time and resin will it take. So get it on your memory card, stick it to your printer, and you are ready.
The second thing is that you should probably turn on door detection function. And that simply means that the printing will go on only if there is the yellow transparent cover over the machine. Now it's enabled. Okay, so it was enabled anyway. Now when you are working with the resin, I wouldn't advise to drink this. Anyway, according to instruction guide, you should wear a pair of gloves and a mask, apparently. So that's what I'm doing right now. I'm not sure if you can understand me, but hopefully you will see what I'm doing.
Simply pour some resin in there. Now let it sit for a little while, since there are little air bubbles and you don't want them there. Of course, you should keep it as clean as you can.
So now everything is ready, the resin is inside, the files have been sliced, so let's print. Woo! And now we wait. The printing process itself took something under 2 hours, which is super fast. At this point, I took out the printing platform and put it on some paper towels. Honestly, the prints worked out great. So all I had to do is get them off using this scraper, and I put the excess resin into a sealed container for later usage. And be sure to store that in a dark place. Right before cleaning my miniatures in Wash and Cure 2, which I also got from Anycubic, I cleansed everything that was stained by liquid resin. Simply going over everything with a paper towel and then rubbing it with IPA is enough. To clean my miniatures, I have used the mentioned Wash and Cure 2, which was also filled with IPA, just so it was enough to cover my miniatures. Now, if you don't have a Wash and Cure 2, you can simply get a container, fill it with IPA and wash it there. But honestly, this bad boy makes it so easy. The miniatures were gently put inside, the container was sealed, and the washing program was set to 10 minutes. By the way, this definitely doesn't sound healthy. I think you know the drill. You simply wait, you can take a few selfies if you wanna, and once it is over, I took out the miniatures to let them dry before curing them. By washing the miniatures, you get rid of the residual resin that is still on them, but still you have to make them harder so they won't fall apart easily by exposing them to UV light. It is also at this point before curing that you might wanna remove supports from your miniatures, since it will be easier as it is a little bit softer. I have chosen to leave the supports be and set up my wash and cure for curing program.
Nice.
Once the setup was done, I decided to put there just one miniature because I was not sure if it's gonna cure evenly with more than that. Honestly, if you guys put there more than one miniature, let me know because I am a noob. Anyway, this is not a big deal, since according to the guide, it should take just around 2 minutes for such miniature, which is just enough time to take more selfies. So I repeated this process for every miniature, and here are the results. I think it worked out just great, It's super precise. I think that you can even print display level miniatures. When I compare this to the result from the other printer, not only is this better quality, but also it is way faster. Printing these three miniatures took just around 2 hours. Unfortunately, cleaning the resin is not all that fun, but other than that, there are no downsides as far as I can see. Honestly, I'm not sure what I'm gonna do with my old 3D printer when I have my Photon Mono, because clearly I am not able to print well on that. But listen, I am sure that I must be doing something wrong, okay? Either way, I am so excited about the possibilities. I am even surprised that it went without any issues. I sort of expected that it will take more than one try. And actually, I think it proves how easy it is for you. I wanna thank Anycubic for sponsoring this video. If they didn't contact me, I probably wouldn't give 3D printing a second chance, but since they did, now I have another tool in my arsenal to paint more exciting miniatures for you guys. Definitely check out the link to Anycubic's website down in the description, because if you wanna start with 3D printing and support this channel at the same time, now is the chance to do so. Once again, if you like the video, consider subscribing, and if you want to help others get better at painting and printing miniatures, give this video a thumbs up so that way YouTube gods will know that they should take this video and recommend it to them. And as always, see you in the next one. Bye!